A high-speed rail network with over 11,000 kilometers of track in service, where trains move faster than a speeding bullet. This is what the Chinese have been able to achieve, breaking milestones in record speed as the country powers towards breathtaking levels of development in the sector. The high-speed rail network today connects more than 100 cities, with trains clocking more than 300 kilometers in an hour. And this is us, chugging along at snail pace. A giant network, the Indian Railways has a track length of more than 1,15,000 kilometers, spread over a distance of 65,000. With over 7,500 stations, our trains ferry more than 24 million passengers daily. As Prime Minister Narendra Modi gives a green signal for a high-speed corridor between Ahmedabad and Mumbai, Headlines Today carries out a ground check to ascertain the distance we have to cover to realize our speed dream. We start on parallel journeys to draw a comparison between us and them. Narendra Modi started out by selling tea outside a train station. And now as Prime Minister, he has plans of reviving the Indian Railways, introducing high-speed engines worthy of our economy. But what are the challenges that Narendra Modi faces? We're going to find out on our journey, starting from New Delhi. Our destination is Jaipur.
We're at the railway station and we're waiting inside to get the tickets. But till then, I could roughly show you what this looks like. Yes, very interestingly, what we see at the airports in India, I'm seeing at the railway station. The kind of air hostesses you see there are ready to help people. The same kind of people here to help the passengers. And this is the real picture. Yes, sounds very interesting and very promising. So we're ready for the stunner, the bullet. Let's go.
A fully air-conditioned station, airport-type baggage and security checks, and state-of-the-art interiors. This is what we're competing against. Back home at the New Delhi railway station, the poor state of facilities come as no surprise.
While looking for a glass of clean drinking water at the New Delhi railway station, this is what the station has to offer. Would you like to drink out of these taps? Look at the surrounding area, extremely dirty. There's no one who's cleaned this for hours at end. The option that you have is to buy a bottle of drinking water. It would lead to more littering and clearly it's not more eco-friendly.
To board a train, you have to go up a long flight of stairs. There are no elevators and the escalators are often out of order. You have to wrestle your way through a sea of humanity, moving between New Delhi railway station's 16 platforms. It's obviously not something that senior citizens and physically disabled persons can do without being hugely inconvenienced. The platforms are often lined with garbage and there are no provisions to keep stray animals away from the railway tracks. Meanwhile, back in Shanghai, it's a smooth ride across platforms for Anjana.
From the railway station, we've reached the platform and it's now my turn to get into the bullet train and feel the experience of 350 kilometers per hour. Yes, we're boarding and it's number 8. So now it's time to get into the bullet.
Shatabdis and Rajdhanis are some of the best trains that the Indian Railways can boast of. But can they match up to the high-quality bullet trains in China? We're about to board the Ajmer Rajdhani to Jaipur. Let's find out.
The interiors of the Shanghai-Beijing Super Express are extremely impressive. Overhead baggage compartments like you have on flights ensure all luggage is safely tucked in before takeoff. No leaking ACs, no garbage on the floor and no paan stains. The bullet trains aren't just fast, they're also spotlessly clean, offering a world-class travel experience.
The picture is for you to see. Luxury, comfort, style and speed all together on the bullet. But let's compare with the Indian Railways. Actually, Indian Railways has become the picture of filth, dirt, train accidents, discomfort. So the comparison is for you to see. But the big thing is that we're on the train from Shanghai to Beijing, roughly 13 to 1400 kilometers, and we're going to cover it in a time span of about 4.5 hours, which means we're already reaching a speed of 300 kilometers per hour. And all this could be ours very soon.
Back on the Delhi-Jaipur Shatabdi, we're booked on an executive class coach. It's the best high-speed train that the country has to offer, but it's a bumpy ride.
Chinese bullet trains are very smooth. A lot of times you can't even make out that you're on the move. Let's try and see if Indian trains are equally stable. I have these two batteries here with me. I'm going to place them on this tray and see if they're able to survive the jitters. Clearly not. This is what you have to deal with while traveling, while eating also. It's a problem where you're having a sip of coffee and suddenly there's a jolt. You can spill it all over. This is not something that you have to encounter in bullet trains that are being promoted in China.
Even as the train races at 300 kilometers per hour, immense speed, let's do a little reality check on the kind of stability you have inside the bullet train. I have with me two batteries. Let's place them here on the floor and let's see how it goes. Here. I've placed both the batteries on the floor, and by the movement you can understand how stable it is inside the train.
The Chinese high-speed train offers a range of cuisine to choose from.
You have a little kiosk here, like you can shop for coffee, if you want fruits you can shop from here. So it's complete fun for people who are traveling on the bullet. It's my turn now, so I need one black coffee and what about this? Maybe I can take this, one of this. We're next to the pantry and this is what it looks like. We just took a rough picture. Food plates, well packed, pre-cooked, are all being kept in the pantry.
No such facilities on our Shatabdi. Half an hour into our journey and the service begins. The food cart rolls into the compartment and the catering staff starts handing out water bottles along with coffee and tea sachets. This is a luxury that is available only on Shatabdis and Rajdhanis. The morning coffee is followed by breakfast, packaged by Meals on Wheels.
The quality of food in the Shatabdi does meet your bare minimum requirements, but it's nothing special. I've ordered a vegetarian breakfast. I've got cutlets and two slices of brown bread, a little bit of butter. There's also an option of South Indian breakfast, but if you're looking for anything high-end, it's not available even on one of India's finest trains.
And we're not the only ones drawing comparisons between the Chinese Dragon and the Indian Snail Rail. 29-year-old Aman Gulati is a regular customer of the Indian Railways. As India toys with the idea of introducing a high-speed diamond quadrilateral, Aman says the need of the hour is to improve existing infrastructure rather than investing in new ventures.
Better concentrate on improvising the services for the users, especially rather than going for just trial for some bullet trains or something, which takes a lot of investment. As far as our country is concerned, we don't have that much exchequer's money with the government. So first he should better concentrate on improving these present services so that user may feel like, yes, we are using the best services because we have the largest network in the world.
And Aman is not the only unhappy customer on board.
At times, I see in this executive class, there's a leakage in the compartment. There's from leakages there from the top. Then while returning, you see the condition of the quality of foodstuff which is served in the evening. That's not up to the mark, simply not up to the mark. We compare ourselves to the world-class kind of railways. We want to have bullet trains. We want to have no second thought. We should actually have. This is the time when we should have all these things. But we really need to understand the existing infrastructure that needs a lot of maintenance, that needs a lot of elevation. Unless that's there, how can we just think of something else beyond this?
Very simple message to Mr. Modi that basics, like focus on basics, like we have enough network. We are the world's largest network. We need basic civics, like, cleaning, sanitation, securities. This required just discipline.
Well, they are thinking of bullet trains and all that. Inko jo existing facilities hain, unko to improve kare. बाद में ये बुलेट ट्रेन की बात कर रहे हैं अब जो एग्जिस्टिंग फैसिलिटी इनसे मेंटेन नहीं हो रही और वो भी इतनी गंदी हो रही हैं कि आदमी खड़े होने में इट वॉज डिफिकल्ट टू स्टैंड इन द प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर अबाउट हाफ एन आवर आई वॉज वेटिंग फॉर द ट्रेन इतना गंदा है।
Coming up next, can the Indian elephant compete with the Chinese dragon in spite of issues of safety, security and sanitation? One of the largest rail networks of the world, the Indian Railways ferries 8,900 million passengers annually, but it's found shockingly lacking in basic amenities.
Hygiene and sanitation are issues that most passengers complain about. Let's take a look at the kind of toilets that are available on the Shatabdi, one of the finest trains that India has to offer. There's water spilled over, the toilets are obviously stinking. Why is it that our trains have to serve like a moving litter box? Why can't we have suction toilets that are available on the flights as well? If you look, if you compare our toilets to those available on the bullet trains, there's a marked difference. This is something that the Indian Railways needs to focus on. Travel becomes extremely inconvenient if you have dirty toilets. These are long journeys that people have to undertake, and it's extremely uncomfortable if you don't have access to a clean bathroom.
No such complaints coming from passengers on the Chinese bullet who are literally pampered while on the move.
I want to give you a rough feel of this place between two compartments. There are fire extinguishers in case of any emergency. At every second step you find them. Then in case you want to throw something, these are all closed cables and you can put your thing into the dustbin. Very neatly done, very neatly organized so that the train remains absolutely clean. But now from here, we will move on to the next part. Because I want to give you a feel of what the toilets and the washrooms here look like. Interestingly, very small but clean. You can say it gives you a feel of the kind of washrooms we've seen in our aeroplanes. The vacuum suction flush systems are in place. The ones that you have on the aeroplanes and definitely not in Indian Railways. So with this, you can understand the kind of system that is in place. Roughly the other side, here. The soap wash, everything is in place. So you get a feel of actually coming to a neat and tidy place. Every 5 to 10 minutes, there's a woman who comes here to do the cleaning.
Prime Minister Modi's proposal of unveiling a diamond quadrilateral connecting the four metros with trains rolling at 320 kilometers per hour has got passengers dreaming about a faster future. On board the Shanghai-Beijing Express, Anjana is able to cover 1,318 kilometers in under 5 hours by travelling at a speed of 330 kilometers per hour. Back home, the journey from Delhi to Jaipur, which is roughly 270 kilometers, takes almost as long.
Speed is a huge issue for the Indian Railways. We are on board one of the fastest trains in the country, the Shatabdi Express. But this train also covers the distance between Jaipur and Delhi, which is approximately 300 kilometers in 4.5 hours. If you compare this timing to that of the bullet train in China, the Chinese bullet train would have covered the distance in only 1 hour. So I have my coffee and my fruits in my hand, but very interestingly, at the speed of 300 kilometers per hour, I had no problem in moving around here. There is no problem of holding onto the sides or the coffee just pouring over. Hi. So the coffee pouring over, well, that is not a menace actually inside this train, in spite of the fact that we are moving at a speed of 300 kilometers per hour.
But apart from speed, there are more pressing issues that need to be addressed. Harvinder Pal Singh has been working with the Indian Railways for more than 3 decades. A ticket collector who is part of the Rajdhani Shatabdi crew, Pal says the absence of railway police officials on board worries him.
इस रूट पे पुलिस है ही नहीं। इसके बारे में हम हाई अथॉरिटीज को काफी बार लिख चुके हैं, लेकिन पर्टिकुलर अजमेर शताब्दी में जहां फॉरेनर्स वगैरह काफी लोग आते हैं, क्योंकि अजमेर शरीफ बहुत बड़ी दरगाह है जहाँ ज़ियारत करने हर लोग जाते हैं, और पुष्कर है जहाँ उसके मेले में इंटरनेशनल लेवल के कस्टमर आते हैं। इस रूट पे सिक्योरिटी नहीं है, बाकी और शताब्दियों में हमारी आरपीएफ की सिक्योरिटी है।
पंद्रह का ये रेल बजे देश को अधिक गति देने वाला, रेलवे को अधिक आधुनिक बनाने वाला। नागरिकों को अधिक सुरक्षा और सेवा देने वाला सिद्ध हो।
So far, what we've seen is Lalu Yadav and Mamata Banerjee giving a green signal to trains for their home states. And more recently, Sonia Gandhi announcing a coach manufacturing unit for her constituency of Rae Bareli. Will Team Modi be able to implement the dream it's selling to the common man? Will the Indian elephant be able to match the Chinese dragon?
The bullet train journey from Shanghai to Beijing is just over for me, but for India, the journey has just begun.
Our journey finally comes to an end at the Jaipur railway station. Lots of expectations from Prime Minister Narendra Modi, lots of recommendations that people have as to how the Indian railways can be revived. The challenge has been set. Modi's time starts now.